just over, what, an hour and a half to go before Phoebe, Abby, Kieran, Maisie, Harry and Kayla cross the finish line after their epic ride from France, which I know I've been absolutely loving it this week.
Oh, it's been phenomenal this week. Yeah. It really has. There's going to be a great reception for them in Salford, where they're proud. There they are, their proud family and friends are waiting for them. So lovely to see such a great turnout. Brilliant. Oh. Matt.
From all of us here on the road, we just want to say a massive thank you for all of your donations and all of the support that you've shown us along the roadsides this week. It's been absolutely incredible. But of course, this is all about raising money, so let's hear the numbers one more time. Maisie, start us off with a £5 donation.
To donate £5, text the word TEAM to 70405.
Phoebe?
To donate £10, text the word TEAM to 70410.
To donate £20, text the word TEAM to 704. Now, as it's Children in Need Day, there is an option to donate £30 for the whole evening. So if you would like to donate £30, Abby?
To donate £30, text the word TEAM to 70430.
Those texts will cost your donation, plus your standard network message charge, and all of your donation will go to BBC Children in Need. You have to be 16 or over. Please do ask for the bill payer's permission. For full terms and conditions, just go to the website, bbc.co.uk/pudsey, where you can also donate any amount you like online. From all of us here, thank you! Thank you, thank you, thank you! Right, let's bring you up to date with what's been happening today. OK, Kayla, let's go.
It's been 8 days of early starts and relentless cycling. And with tired legs, it's the final push to get to the end.
Goodbye, Chester. Let's get to the finish line, Kayla.
I want to see my family today. That's why I'm excited.
It's really important, actually, today we just remain focused and get there.
Today, we have to cross a river. We've already been through the Channel Tunnel and up a racetrack, so why not aboard a ferry?
We've done about 16 miles, we're at Seacombe and about to cross the River Mersey. Look at this, hello!
And this ride comes with a musical accompaniment. Abby is 16 and from London. A few years back, her world was turned upside down when she was diagnosed with cancer.
When you hear the word cancer, it is a bit, OK, what's going to happen next?
How did your mum deal with it all?
I could see her crying when we got the phone call, and my mum was, like, devastated.
Yeah.
My whole family were. And I think that was the only time we cried together as a family. After that, it was all about, OK, how do we cope? What do we do? I wanted to know for me, is this going to defeat me or not?
You were in hospital at that point. What happened next?
I lost a lot of weight. I weighed 4 stone. My feet caved in, my muscles were caved in.
Yeah.
And like, I couldn't sort of walk properly. In hospital, there were some really bad days because one hour you could be like good and the next hour you can just slope back down.
As if the cancer wasn't hard enough to cope with, Abby also lost her nan and friends she made whilst in hospital.
I didn't really get to grieve over my nan, but I still miss her like so much. She's still with me. Like, I think of her everywhere I go. Think, oh, she won't like this, she won't like that. But I miss her so much. And then all the friends in hospital that I keep passing, I've always got them in me. And like the other day when I was doing the 10 miles, for that last mile, I just had all of them in my head and I just went on doing it for them.
Thankfully, after further treatment, Abby is now in remission.
And how's life now for you, Abby?
Life, the best it's ever been. What I went through was horrific and I want to let people know out there that's like suffering something similar to me, just keep fighting because I fought and look, I'm still here now.
Please,
There's been a lot of toil and tears riding the rickshaw, but lots of laughs too. This is us.
The Rickshaw Challenge 2018 is underway!
It's not a nice illness.
But just think about how easy this is in comparison to what you've already overcome.
You're right, yeah.
I feel like I can achieve a lot more now than I ever did.
I think I've made friends for life.
Proud of what I've done here, how far I've been able to go in helping others and in helping myself.
Come on, team.
We've had fantastic support along the way, and the people of St. Helens gave us a huge lift this afternoon.
Look at the people, it's unbelievable.
The end is in sight.
Young people have opened up this week and spoken so eloquently about their stories, and credit to Matt as well, because he's the one that, you know, draws it.
Amazing.
They feel so comfortable with them, you know. Alford at the finish line.
To BBC Salford, and thank you so much to the Rock Choir, who are absolutely brilliant. For the past 8 days, they have been battling the pouring rain and many, many hills for Team Rickshaw. And tonight, the end is in sight. And we are here at the finish line and have gathered all their friends and family who are excited to see them and want to celebrate their massive achievement. So let's talk to them. Let's start off with Abby's parents, Nicola and Robert. Abby's been tackling those hills as if she's been on the Tour de France, hasn't she?
Oh, she's been totally amazing. I know she's been doing it with the memory of her four friends who sadly lost their battle with cancer. So she said it in her film earlier. So for Georgia, Jake, Chloe and little Olivia, they were with her all the way.
And then we have Maisie's parents here, Justine and Simon. Now, Maisie has a bone growth disorder and that has made it quite tricky for her, hasn't it?
Oh, very much so. So she hurts when she cycles, when she does exercise. So back, knees, ankles hurt. But she's doing it because if one person with dwarfism sees what she's doing, sees that they can do it and contacts the DSA, then her job is done.
Fantastic. And we have Phoebe's family here. Give us a smile. And Kelvin, big brother. What's it like seeing your little sister tackle the Rickshaw Challenge?
Yeah, to be honest, we didn't know that she could even ride a bike. So the fact that she's done it over these last few days have been truly amazing. Even watching her on TV has been actually quite tiring. So, yeah, we're just truly proud of her. And what she's doing is completely amazing. And we're all behind her.
No, exactly. Now, not only do all the riders have to face Team Rickshaw, but they also have to tell us exactly why they want to take part. And Kayla got to take centre stage on the Graham Norton Show to tell her story.
You're taller than I thought.
Now, I'd like to introduce a wonderful young woman from Northern Ireland who is really inspirational. Kayla is here as part of the team riding a rickshaw. That is quite the cycle ride, rather you than me. Please welcome Kayla!
Hello, I'm 16 and I'm from Northern Ireland. When I was younger, I lived with my mommy. She had blonde hair, blue eyes, and everybody loved her. But she was also an alcoholic, and that made things difficult. When I was about 6, I realised seeing the green cans stacked up around her was a bad sign. I knew that she'd probably pass out, and I was going to have to look after her. I never blamed my mommy for drinking, because I knew that it wasn't her fault. I see it as a disease that nobody can control. It's terrible to see someone you love so much fall down. I always hoped that my mommy would be okay, but in January last year, she suddenly died of pneumonia. My daddy is ill and in a wheelchair, so he's not able to look after me. So I now live with my granda. I now take one day at a time I have hopes and dreams for my future, but it's not always that easy. Throughout it all, I've been helped by the Bogside and Brandway Health Forum. Children Need puts money towards their funding. And it is a healthy, loving centre based in a youth club, and they've been there for me through the toughest times. And I'm so thankful to them. I want to share my story so that our children in the same situation know that they're not alone. Please give what you can.
You did it! You did it! Kayla, everybody!
It's amazing. That must have been so hard to do.
Well, I'm here with Kayla's support worker, Laura, and her auntie, Lee. I just find Kayla so adorable, and she's so inspiring, and she's inspired loads of people back home, hasn't she?
Oh, definitely. We have been supporting her every night and watching her friends and family, and today our school organised a Wear Yellow, and they've done a sponsored cycle, and they've raised over £1,000 for children in need.
Oh, that's brilliant. And Kayla's not the only friends who've been inspired, because Kieran's friends have been busy too. So let's chat to Dan, you're Kieran's foster dad. What's been going on?
Yeah, everybody from the project in the Hub Torvine in Blenavon have been doing their own rickshaw challenge. They started on Tuesday and they finished their 420-something miles today and raised almost £1,000, so they've done really, really well.
We love that, we love that. Now, I'm here with Sharon. It's good to be, for you to be here. Tell us, what's it been like for you to see Kieran do this whole thing?
It's been really emotional. It's been fantastic watching him.
Yeah.
Really great.
And do you think it's changed you as a person and him as a person?
Yeah, definitely.
Brilliant. Thank you so much for being here. And let's move on now to Harry's mum, Jill.
Hi.
Hi. It's good to have you here because you've been with him all week, haven't you?
I have. I've had the privilege to be with them all week. And they are such an amazing group of young people. And they've got so much love for each other. I just feel so honoured that I've been able to observe that all week. They've been amazing.
And Steve, what's it done for you as a family?
Oh, we've all really enjoyed watching Harry and the rest of the team achieve so much, and the support they've got from the public. It's been really inspiring for us.
Brilliant. Well, you'll all be reunited with everyone very soon. Hopefully the guys will be over the finish line in about an hour and a half. Make sure you stay tuned because they'll be on Children Need later. Oh.
Is okay, the final push for Team Rickshaw, mm-hmm. who are due to cross the finish line at about 10 to 9
right.
tonight.
Yes, and with them as ever is Matt, who has sent us his final update on the road to Salford.
Well, it's been a final day of mixed emotions, celebration at what Team Rickshaw have achieved, but sadness that it's almost over. So, Maisie, what are you going to take away from this week?
I'm probably going to take determination, positivity, and Macaton.
Oh, Macaton. Okay, Phoebe.
Things get better when you persist.
Mm-hmm. Harry, I'm coming round to you, my man. Go for it. Never give up. Strong words, my friend. Kayla?
Friends for life, confidence and independence.
Abby, you're hiding. Come forward.
Oh, where?
There you go. Go on.
I'm going to take away strength and independence. Mm-hmm.
Kieran?
Some absolutely brilliant memories with some brilliant people that I call family.
Yeah. Well, I think we've probably had the best bike ride ever. And, do you know, I just want you to think about this. Think about what impact Team Rickshaw have had on you this week. And then spare a thought for the fact that there is probably a Maisie, a Phoebe, a Harry, a Kayla, an Abby and a Kieran that's living in your community. And they probably live just around the corner. I want to thank everybody who has donated this week and shown all of their support, because those children that probably do live very close to you are relying on those donations tonight for the chance of a better future. The chance of a future that surely every single child deserves. In an hour and a half, this lot are going to be standing in front of a total. If you haven't texted yet, then it's the price of a couple of coffees. So let's just make sure that that total is the one that this brave and determined team really do deserve. We'll see you at the finish line.
Well, a big thank you to Boyzone. Before we go, I'd like to say a big thank you on behalf of everyone at
yes.
the One Show for supporting Team Rickshaw. Yep.
And a big well done to Matt. And that's all left to do is to get our ears on
that's
and count down to Children Need 2018. So are we ready?
We're ready.
Here we go.